So the Hyperloop is a concept created by Elon Musk, and it's coined the fifth mode of transportation. You have train, plane, car, and boat. And basically the Hyperloop, what's so special about it is you're traveling on a pod in a zero pressure tube very quickly and efficiently. Elon Musk only released like a concept of what he thinks the Hyperloop pod should be, but there's no set Hyperloop pod.
Musk has engaged the creativity of university student teams all over the world, pitting them against each other in a series of competitions. The University of Maryland's team, UMD Loop, placed fifth overall in the first competition, held in January at the SpaceX Hyperloop test track in Hawthorne, California. The team is ready for the second competition, starting August 25th.
When we get to SpaceX, it's a bunch of teams coming together to try and compete to be the fastest Hyperloop pod in SpaceX's tube. And there are 24 teams there competing. And basically, each team has a set of requirements that they need to achieve in order to compete. The team consists of about 35 to 40 members from a variety of majors. All sorts of backgrounds are needed to make sure that we have a successful pod. We have physics, aerospace, electrical engineers. We even have a PR team.
This is the Hyperloop pod. You're seeing the frame. All the subsystems are really integrated into the frame. Then we have our aeroshell, which is made out of carbon fiber. And this was quite a process. It took a really big CNC that we got from a manufacturer in DC to cut out a mold, and we laid up the carbon fiber ourselves.
The UMD Loop team learned a lot of important lessons from the first competition. The team's new pod, Nemesis, has many technological improvements. The team hopes to field the fastest pod in the second competition.
One of the things that has proven to be a bit challenging, though we've, I think, dealt well with it, is just the really compressed time frame. The first competition was in January, towards the end of January, and in order to actually even be eligible for the second phase, you had to have some significant redesigns of your pod. They didn't want to see the same thing cycled through again.
The timing of the competition couldn't be better. About a month before round two, Musk announced provisional approval to build a Hyperloop track connecting Washington, D.C. and New York City. A Hyperloop ready to carry passengers and cargo could be even closer than the team members imagined.
The students have got a really good opportunity to participate in something that is unique and is really transformative for the transportation industry. I think a lot of them will look back 50 years from now and realize just what an impact their efforts had. So it gives them a really good experience that ties everything together well before they graduate, so they'll be well prepared when they leave the university setting.
The Hyperloop is just such a new technology right now that it really does feel exciting to be on the frontier of it, especially going into the competition. So it's very cool to see a bunch of different teams, like they were faced with the same challenges, and then I just imagine in the future, like, we're going to be able to look back at this and see parts from each pod come into the real one.